Understanding the impacts of inflation on gross domestic product, GDP. Understanding the economy requires an examination of various metrics, two of the most critical being the gross domestic product, GDP, and inflation. GDP represents the total value of all goods and services produced over a specific time period within a country, acting as a comprehensive scorecard of the economic health of a country. Inflation, on the other hand, signifies the rate at which the general level of prices for goods and services is rising, subsequently eroding the purchasing power of money. Though these two concepts appear distinct, they are intricately interconnected, with inflation significantly impacting GDP in various ways. This video explores these impacts, shedding light on how inflation can stimulate or dampen economic growth as indicated by the GDP. The inflation-GDP relationship, a delicate balance. The relationship between inflation and GDP is not linear, rather, it is curvilinear, with both low and high inflation potentially detrimental to GDP growth, depending on the circumstances. In moderate levels, inflation can have a positive effect on GDP. This is primarily due to the anticipation of higher prices in the future, which can incentivize consumers to purchase goods and services now, leading to an increase in consumption, a key component of GDP. Similarly, businesses may increase production and investment to take advantage of the rising prices, further stimulating GDP growth. However, when inflation is too high or too low, the effects on GDP can become negative. High inflation can lead to uncertainty about future inflation, leading to less spending and investment by both households and firms. This can slow economic growth, reducing the GDP. On the other hand, very low or negative inflation, deflation, can also be harmful, as consumers may delay spending in expectation of further price falls, and businesses may cut back on investment due to lower profitability. Inflation's impact on the components of GDP. To delve deeper into how inflation impacts GDP, it is beneficial to examine its effect on the four main components of GDP: consumption, investment, government spending, and net exports. Consumption. Inflation impacts consumers' purchasing power, which, in turn, influences their consumption behaviors. Moderate inflation can encourage spending, which positively impacts GDP. Conversely, high inflation erodes the value of money, making goods and services more expensive and possibly decreasing consumer spending. Meanwhile, deflation may lead to decreased consumption, as consumers wait for prices to fall further. Investment. Uncertainty about future inflation rates can negatively impact business investment, as companies may be unsure about future costs and revenues. When inflation is high, businesses might hesitate to make long-term investments due to the unpredictable nature of costs and potential returns. Conversely, moderate inflation might stimulate investment, since businesses can pass on increased costs to consumers in the form of higher prices. Government spending. High inflation can strain government budgets as it increases the costs of goods and services, leading to reduced government spending, a component of GDP. Moreover, if a government decides to combat high inflation by tightening monetary policy, it may lead to decreased public spending, and hence, lower GDP. Net exports. Inflation can affect a country's competitiveness in the global market. If a country's inflation rate is higher than that of its trading partners, its goods become relatively more expensive, leading to a decline in exports and a rise in imports, negatively impacting GDP. On the other hand, if a country's inflation is lower than that of its trading partners, its goods become comparatively cheaper, potentially increasing net exports and hence, GDP. Inflation's indirect impact through monetary policy. Inflation also indirectly affects GDP through its influence on monetary policy. Central banks often increase interest rates to control high inflation. While this can help slow inflation, it can also have the side effect of reducing GDP growth. Higher interest rates make borrowing more expensive, which can dampen consumption and investment. These reductions can lead to slower GDP growth or even a contraction. Conversely, in periods of low inflation or deflation, central banks might lower interest rates to stimulate the economy, making borrowing cheaper and encouraging spending and investment, thereby supporting GDP growth. The role of expectations. Expectations play a significant role in the relationship between inflation and GDP. If households and businesses expect higher inflation, they may increase spending and investment now to avoid higher costs in the future. This can stimulate GDP growth in the short run. However, if higher inflation is expected to persist, it may lead to less spending and investment due to the increased uncertainty, slowing GDP growth. Similarly, if deflation is expected, consumers might hold off on spending, and businesses could delay investment, both of which could reduce GDP. Inflation has a multifaceted impact on GDP, influenced by the inflation rate, its relation to global inflation rates, the actions of central banks, and inflation expectations. While moderate inflation can stimulate GDP growth, both high inflation and deflation can potentially harm GDP. Therefore, managing inflation is a key task for policymakers to ensure steady, sustainable economic growth. Understanding the nuanced relationship between inflation and GDP is crucial for making informed decisions that drive economic prosperity. Interesting fact, the shoe leather cost of inflation is a concept that represents the costs of reducing money holdings to counteract the effects of inflation. The term comes from the idea that when inflation is high, people would want to minimize their cash holdings due to its rapidly declining purchasing power. In practical terms, people might make more frequent trips to the bank, hence the term shoe leather cost, as one would theoretically wear out their shoes more quickly due to these extra trips, to withdraw smaller amounts of cash for immediate spending needs. While in the modern world of digital banking this might not involve literal trips to the bank, the concept still represents the inconvenience and time wasted managing money in a high inflation environment, which can indirectly impact productivity and, consequently, GDP. This is another fascinating way in which inflation can have broader economic impacts beyond just eroding purchasing power.